Hello friends, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. Today in this video we are going to discuss body fluids and circulation, the most important and also interesting topic called body fluids and circulations. So you know body fluids, we know very well in our body several fluids are there. Especially two types of fluids are present in our body. One is intracellular fluid, which is present inside the cells. The another one is extracellular fluid, which is present outside the cell. So two types of fluids are there. One is intracellular, one is extracellular. Again, the extracellular fluids has three types. One is called tissue fluid, the second one is plasma, the third one is lymph. So in this video we are going to discuss about the blood, especially the components of blood or composition of blood. So what is blood, what are the functions of blood, and what are the components present inside the blood. So this is more important to know the circulation. We know very well about blood. Blood has two components. It is a blood, nothing but it is a special type of fluid. Otherwise we can say blood is a connective tissues. This blood derived from mesoderm during embryological development. The branch of science concerned with the study of blood, blood forming tissues and the disorders associated with them is called hematology. So blood, what is the role, what is the functions? It has several functions. Out of this, three more important functions are there for blood. One is transportation, the second one is regulation, the third one is protection. We see this slide. So first important function is transport. So blood helps to transport various substances from one part to another part of the body. Especially we know that during respiration the gases exchange takes place, oxygen and carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide and oxygen both together called respiratory gases. So these gases, they transport inside the body or circulate inside the body only through blood. So blood helps to transport the gases. Not only gases, the blood transport various nutrients from gastrointestinal tract. After digestion, what happens? Digestive materials are there in the intestine. So this digestive material, for example amino acids, glucose, glycerols, vitamins, other minerals, these are the nutrients. These nutrients are present inside the intestine after digestion. So this nutrition goes throughout the body, throughout the cells and each and every cells for their energy requirement. So this transport once again by blood. And one more transportation is hormones. We know that hormones from endocrine glands, these glands no duct. So what happens, this hormone directly mix with the blood and carries to the target organ. The one more function is it transport the metabolic waste. So concluded, blood has it helps in exchange of gases or transport of respiratory gases. It helps to transport the nutrients, it helps to transport the hormones, it helps to transport the metabolic wastes. So second important function, that is called regulation. The blood regulates the pH. It adjusts and maintains the body temperature also. and also it maintains water content of level. That's called osmotic pressures with the help of various proteins. So second more important function is regulation. Third, one more important function for blood is protection. We know very well about blood has blood cells. Out of these leukocytes, WBC, white blood cells, it helps to protect against diseases by phagocytosis process. It engulfs the microbes, it engulfs the antigens, it gives protection, and also it blood acts as a reservoir for substances like water, electrolytes, and also in one more important function, it performs hemostasis. Hemostasis means maintenance of internal environment. So previously we discussed about the functions of blood. Now we see that what are the properties of blood. Blood, it is a slightly alkaline in nature. It's red in color. It's a common thing. The red color is because of hemoglobin. It is a respiratory pigment which is present in RBC. So the color of blood is red. But whereas in arteries it is bright red, whereas in veins it is dark red. The total body mass of fluid is only 8%. Maybe salty taste. The temperature of blood, normal temperature is 38 degrees Celsius. It was more viscous than water, 3 to 4 times more viscous than the water. The what are the volume, what is the volume of blood? So in an adult healthy person, the volume of blood is 5 to 6 liters. Now we see that one more slide is here. Components of blood, the most important topic in that circulation topic, especially blood circulation and body fluids. So blood is nothing but a alkaline fluid. It is a connective tissue. It has two components. It has two major components. One is called plasma and one more is called formed elements. The plasma, the percentage is 55% total volume, whereas formed elements 45%. These formed elements, otherwise you can say blood cells, it has three types of cells. One, RBC or erythrocyte. Second one is WBC, white blood cells, or otherwise called leukocytes. The third one is platelets, otherwise it is called thrombocytes. So these are the three important cells which is present in formed elements. So once again, blood has two components. One is plasma and formed elements. Formed element has how many cells? Three cells: erythrocytes, leukocytes, thrombocytes. Again, you see that leukocytes, there are two different types are there, based on the presence of granules in the cytoplasm. So this WBC leukocytes depends on the presence of granules in the cytoplasm. Again, it is classified into two types. One is a granulocyte and another is agranulocytes. Granulocytes means it has, these cells has granules in the cytoplasm. It has three types: neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil. Whereas agranulocytes, there is no granules in the cytoplasm. A means nil, so no granulocytes in the cytoplasm, so they are called agranulocytes. It is again divided into two types of cells. One is called monocyte and lymphocytes. So these are the major components of blood. One by one we will see what is plasma, what are the components present in plasma, which is plasma, what are the functions of plasma, and at the same time we are going to discuss the formed elements also. So what is RBC, what is WBC, what is platelets, what is the role, what is the function, what is the shape and size, everything we will discuss in this chapter. So first we will see plasma. So what is plasma? Plasma is a pale yellow color liquid. It is a component of a blood that holds the formed elements of blood in suspension. So what are the constituents of plasma? So what are the components of plasma? What is present in the plasma? Already we told that plasma is 55%. In that plasma, water alone 91.5%, nearly 92% is a major component. Plasma nothing but major water. Apart from water, some proteins also there in the plasma. These proteins are called plasma proteins, only 7%. Third, one more component of plasma, that is called other solutes. The concentration is 1.5. So simply you say, in plasma there are three types of substances, three components. The major is water, the second one is proteins, the third one is solutes. So what are the proteins present in the plasma? Simply you can say plasma proteins. Four types of proteins are there. One is albumin, globulin, prothrombin, fibrinogen. We will see the detailed features of albumin. What is the function? What is globulin? What is prothrombin? What is the role of fibrinogen? So we will discuss later. The other solutes. What are the solutes? Electrolytic ions. It was given here. Sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, chloride, HCO3, SO4. These are the electrolyte ions are present in the solutes. These are dissolved in plasma. And some gases also there in plasma, especially oxygen, carbon dioxide and N2. And nutrition also there. Glucose, amino acid, fatty acids. These are the important nutrients present in plasma. And also waste products also present in plasma, especially urea, uric acid, ammonia, creatinine. So these are the clear picture that what is plasma, what are the components of plasma. Now we see that what are the functions of plasma. We told that plasma has water, 92%, nearly 92. So what is the role of this water? It helps in absorption, and also it transport and releases heat. Some proteins also there, I told, especially albumins, globulin, prothrombin and fibrinogen. Out of this, this albumin is a protein, plasma protein. It is more essential or most important for the osmotic balance of cells or tissues. The second one is globulin. This plasma protein mainly involved in immune function. Not only immune function, and also it helps in transport of ion, hormones and lipids. Whereas prothrombin and fibrinogen, these are the plasma proteins which is present in plasma, helps in blood clotting. Otherwise you can say blood coagulation. So this is essential for blood coagulation, these two plasma proteins. If there is no plasma proteins like prothrombin and fibrinogen, blood clot will not occur during injury. Then what happens? The continuous blood flow will take place. It leads to various complications regarding some disorders. Whereas one more function of plasma is called electrolytic ions are there. This electrolytic ions maintains the pH buffering of the blood. So next, in this slide we see that so far we discussed the plasma. What is plasma? What are the components? what are the functions, what are the proteins. We discuss in detail. Now we see that formed elements, the other part, second major part, component of blood. Formed elements are basically, you can say, blood cells. Blood cells, already I told three types of cells. One is called erythrocyte, leukocyte and thrombocytes. First we see that what is erythrocyte, red blood cells. These cells are circular and biconcave shape. Its most important feature is it does not have nucleus. In the body cells, all the cells has nucleus, but RBC in mammals, in adult, there is no nucleate. So you can say non-nucleated. So what is the shape? Circular and biconcave, non-nucleated cells. Not only nucleus, this RBC does not have mitochondria. It does not have ribosomes. It does not have endoplasmic reticulum. Because of this absence of these things, the RBC is facilitate or it increase the surface of absorption of oxygen. It take more oxygen. So it will helps to carry more oxygen during circulation. So what is the size? RBC are very small in size. The diameter is 7 to 8 mu micron. The thickness is 2.5 mu micron. Already I told that blood is a red color because of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin, nothing but a pigment, respiratory pigment, which is present in RBC alone. It was not present in the WBC and other cells. It is present only in RBC. So because of hemoglobin, the color of blood, the color of RBC is red. This RBC is abundant. It was more in blood. Whereas in male, the RBC counting 5 to 5 million per cubic milliliter. Whereas in female, the RBC is 4.5 to 5.0 milli RBCs per cubic milliliter. So this RBC has a lifespan. This lifespan of RBC is 120 days. So after 120 days, what happens? The old RBCs are destroyed. They are removed in the spleen. New RBCs are produced. So after 120 days, what happens? The old RBCs are destroyed in the spleen. So spleen is called a graveyard of RBC. This RBC, otherwise you can say erythrocytes, it helps, it contains hemoglobin. This hemoglobin helps to transport of respiratory gases, especially during inspiration. The oxygen get inside the alveoli of lungs. From the alveoli of lungs, the oxygen is carried by blood, especially by hemoglobin. This hemoglobin is more important to carry the oxygen to the various cells of the body through blood. Once again, I want to remember, RBC does not have nucleus, mitochondria, ribosomes and endoplasmic reticulum. This helps to increase the oxygen carrying capacity of the cells. RBCs are destroyed in spleen. So this is called, spleen is called graveyard of RBC. During destruction, the hemoglobin which contains iron is reused in bone marrow for synthesis of a new RBC. The synthesis of RBC or erythrocytes is enhanced by a hormone that is called erythropoietin. This hormone is secreted by the kidney. With the help of this hormone, there is an erythropoietin, RBCs are synthesized. The formation or synthesis of RBC is called erythropoiesis. So here we want to make a note. Erythropoietin is a hormone secreted by kidney which helps in synthesis of RBC. The synthesis of RBC or production of RBC is known as erythropoiesis. Where the erythropoiesis occurs in adult, the RBC synthesis takes place in red bone marrow of long bones, especially hip bones, breast bone and ribs. So in these three bones, especially in the red bone marrow, not in yellow bone marrow, only in red bone marrow, the RBCs are synthesized in adult. Whereas in children's bone marrow, of all the bones where the erythropoiesis occurs, whereas in the fetus, RBC synthesis takes place in liver and spleen alone. When the number of RBCs increases, it is called polycythemia. Poly means many, cyte means cells. So increased number of RBC is called polycythemia. Sometimes it will decrease in number. This decrease in number of RBC is called erythroponia. So what is the function of RBC? We told already, it helps to transport oxygen from lungs to tissues. And also it transport the carbon dioxide from tissues to lungs. So simply you can say this RBC or erythrocytes helps to transport oxygen and carbon dioxide. The normal blood contains 13 to 15 gram of hemoglobin per 100 ml of blood. One RBC contains 250 million molecules of hemoglobin, whereas one hemoglobin or each molecule of hemoglobin carries 4 molecules of oxygen, so that the oxygen supply is always in a required manner. Next, so far we discussed the RBC, erythrocytes, mainly its properties, functions, size, shape, everything. Now we'll discuss the leukocytes, white blood cells. A special feature is there for WBC, that is, it is amoeboid movement. It has amoeboid movement. It moves like amoeba. So it is an amoeboid movement cell, amoeboid cell, you can say amoeboid cells. And one more important function, one more important feature of WBC, that is, it has nucleus. This is the main difference between RBC and WBC. Whereas in RBC, there is no nucleus, but WBC, it has nucleus. It is colorless because hemoglobin is not present. Whereas in RBC, hemoglobin is present. Because of hemoglobin, the RBCs are red in color. Whereas WBC are white in color or colorless, you can say. This colorless because of absence of hemoglobin, and also it is translucent. The size of WBC, 12 to 15 mu micron. The count of WBC when compared to RBC, WBC, white blood cells, in adult, 5,000 to 10,000 WBCs are per milliliter blood. Lifespan is only 10 to 13 days. When compared to RBC, it is very less. In RBC, it was 120 days, whereas in WBC, it is only 10 to 13 days. Very short lifetime of WBC. The formation of WBC is known as leukoposis. Where it occurs? It occurs in, especially in adult, liver, spleen, tonsil and bone marrow. So these are the important places where the formation of or synthesis of WBC occurs. Whereas in fetus, it is only in liver and spleen. Sometimes the increased number of WBC is also present. So increase in number of WBC is known as leukocytosis. A decrease in number of WBC is known as leukopenia. Pathological increase in number of WBC is known as leukemia. Otherwise, you can say blood cancer. A continuous increase of WBC due to infection, that is called leukemia. Now we see that types of WBC, types of white blood cells or leukocytes. We know very well WBC, the police force of the body, protects the body from infections. This leukocytes, white blood cells, has two types. It classified into two types. One is called granular leukocytes, the another one is called agranular leukocytes. This classification depends on the presence of granules in the cytoplasm. If the granules are present in the cytoplasm, then it is called granular. If there is no granules in the cytoplasm, then it is called agranular. Granular leukocytes again has three types. One is called neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils. The percentage also given here, neutrophils 62%, the most abundant. Eosinophil only 2 to 3%. Basophil very less percentage, very least percentage, only 0.4%. Whereas agranulocyte again has two types. One is called lymphocytes and monocytes. Lymphocytes are 30%, 30, whereas monocytes are 5.3%. Now we will see the detailed features of granular leukocytes, granular white blood cells. We know that there are three types of granular leukocyte: neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil. So first one is neutrophil, otherwise you can say heterophils, or you can say PMN. The percentage is 60 to 65. So out of these three types, these are the most common and most abundant cells. The percentage is more. These neutrophils, polymorphonucleus, that is called PMN. The nucleus is there, but 3 to 4 lobes are there. You see the diagram, first one. There are 3 to 4 lobes are present. These lobes of nucleus connected with delicate thread. It was very clear in that picture. You see that neutrophils, 3 to 4 lobes are there. This is called nucleus. These lobes connected with a delicate thread. So what is the function? This neutrophil, it destroy the bacteria by a process called phagocytosis. It engulf the bacteria, it engulf the antigens or microbes, especially bacteria. It was produced in bone marrow. The first one is very clear, neutrophils, otherwise called heterophils, otherwise called PMN, polymorphonucleus. So the nucleus is 3 to 4 lobes. It was stained with a neutral dye. One more important feature. The second one is eosinophils, or you can say acidophils. The percentage is 2 to 3%. In this eosinophil, only two lobes. Nucleus are two lobes. Nucleus with two lobes. This nucleus, two lobes are joined by thin strands. See the picture, second one. Two lobes are there. It was joined by a thin strands. It was stained with acidic dye. The first one is by neutral dye. Example, hemotoxylin. The second one, acidophils or eosinophils, they are stained with acidic dye. Example, eosin. So what is the function of these acidophils or eosinophils? It increases during infections and in allergic reactions. It was non-phagocytic, whereas neutrophils are phagocytic nature. It is non-phagocytic. It also produced in bone marrow. The third one is basophils, the least, very lowest concentration, lowest amount, what is called basophils. This also has a nucleus with several lobes. it was stained with a basic dye that is called methylene blue. These basophils are very essential or important because it liberate, it secrete secretions, some secretions, especially heparin, serotonin, and histamine during allergic reactions. So these secretions are essential. Heparin, we know that very well, it is highly essential to prevent the blood clot within the blood vessels. Inside the blood vessels, the blood always in liquid form. It should not become clot. This prevention of clot within the blood vessels maintained by heparin. So this heparin is synthesized or liberated in the basophil. And also it involved in inflammatory response, during inflammatory response. It also produced in bone marrow. So these are the three important types of granular WBC. Next one, agranulocytes. These agranulocytes, because of absence of granules in cytoplasm. Here we can see two types are there. One is a lymphocyte and another one is called monocyte. So lymphocyte, 28% total amount, total value. What are the features? These lymphocytes are the smallest of leukocytes. When compared to other neutrophil, basophil, eosinophil, monocyte, these are the smallest of leukocyte. But it has a large round nucleus. Lymphocytes are classified into two types. One is called T lymphocyte. The second one is called B lymphocyte. T lymphocytes produce in thymus, whereas B lymphocyte produce in bone marrow. So what is the function of T cell and B cell? It involved in immune system, especially the T cells produce cell mediated immunity. Shortly we can say CMI. So which is responsible for CMI? T cells, T lymphocyte. Whereas B cells, it helps to produce antibodies. It gives humoral immunity or antibody mediated immunity. So both the cells, T cell and B cell, are essential for immune system of human body. And it was produced in bone marrow, spleen, thymus and tonsil. The second one is of agranulocyte, that is called monocyte. Monocyte, otherwise called macrophages. These monocytes are going to convert, or they will change the structure into macrophages during infections. It is a phagocytic cell, similar to mast cell. It has nucleus, but the shape is kidney shape. Whereas in lymphocyte, a large round nucleus is present. Here, nucleus is present, but kidney shape. The same monocytes or macrophages, which is present in the central nervous system, they are called microglia. The macrophages, which is present in the liver, they are called Kupffer cell. The macrophages, which is present in the pulmonary region, in the lungs, they are called alveolar macrophages. These macrophages are monocytes, are percentage 1-3%. It involves in ingestion of microorganism. It ingests the microorganisms. It was produced in bone marrow. The third important formed element, that is called thrombocytes. Otherwise, you can call blood platelets. These blood platelets, the shape is circular biconvex. An RBC, it was biconcave, but here biconvex. It also non-nucleated like RBC. In RBC also nucleus is not present. Here also nucleus is not present. These platelets or thrombocytes are produced from megakaryocytes present in bone marrow. The size of platelets are 2 to 4 mu micron. It's a count. The counting of thrombocyte, blood platelets are very essential for a healthy person. So this platelets are always their normal range is 1,50,000 to 4 lakh platelets in milliliter blood. So lifespan is only 5 to 9 days, very short period. When compared to WBC, 10 to 13 period, whereas RBC 120 days. But out of this is a shortest lifespan. But it's more function, it's more important for blood clotting during injury. So when injury takes place, the arteries will cut, the blood will release immediately within 3 to 4 or 4 to 5 minutes. The blood get stopped because of blood coagulation, a life-saving mechanism. It is present in the body with the help of blood platelets. So this blood platelets or thrombocytes are highly essential for blood coagulation process. The formation of thrombocytes is called thrombophlebitis. The platelets are the fragments of large cell called megakaryocytes that remain in the bone marrow. The increased number of platelets is known as thrombocytosis, whereas in decreased number of platelets is known as thrombocytopenia. So what is blood clotting? Simply you can say a definition here. Blood clotting is a process in which blood loses its fluidity and becomes a jelly like mass few minutes after it is shed out. So once again we will revise the topic in a short time with an easy manner. Also here we see the slide. The human body is given. In the human body, blood alone, the body mass already told, only 8%. The other fluids and tissues are 92%. The blood has two components. You see that picture. Here the yellow color portion is there, and below that the red color part is there. The upper yellow color portion part, that is called plasma, 55%. The lower red color part is called formed elements. So these are the two main composition of blood. So what is plasma? We discussed earlier in detail, but here we will see once again what is plasma. It contains three important components. The main components is water, 92%, proteins, that is plasma proteins, 7%, other solutes only 1%. Whereas in formed elements, three types of cells are there. It was given here, the red color part, you see that erythrocytes are there, leukocytes and platelets. So in plasma, the proteins are plasma proteins, four types of proteins already I told. One is albumin, globulin, fibrinogen, prothrombin. These are called plasma proteins. Other solutions are there, ions, nutrients, waste product, gases, regulatory substances. These are called solutes, which is present in the plasma, only 1%. So in blood cells, the leukocytes are five types based on the presence of granules, agranulocyte and granulocytes. Out of these five, neutrophils are more abundant, more common, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils and basophils. So far we have discussed the composition of blood. Thank you, students.